And I'm Wooly.
Hi, I'm... No, I don't want you here. Don't you get that?
But Amanda, I'm your best friend.
My best friend? All you do is get up. Hi, I'm Amanda.
And I'm Wooly.
Today we are working on a very special project. It's a project that will take a lot of patience.
Patience is a very good quality to have.
Patience is a very good quality to have. It means staying calm even when something or someone bothers you over and over again. Today, we are building a birdhouse so more birds will come to the yard.
Why are we out here before the sun is up? It's so dark outside.
Well, this project is going to take a long time. Have a little patience, Wooly.
Well, I still think we could use a flashlight or something. I'm gonna bump into something.
You can go back inside if you want. You don't have to be out here with me. What's something you have built that took a lot of patience? Why would you waste your time doing that?
I can't wait to see what birds come to visit.
What's your favorite kind of bird? I like those too! Let's get started! The first thing we have to do is cut the length of the wood to the right size. What tool should we use for that? How would we cut wood with that? Guess it's a good thing we're learning about patience today. What can we use to cut the wood? Right! We'll use the saw to cut the wood.
Amanda, shouldn't we have some kind of supervision when we're using tools?
Thanks for the tip, Wooly. Now let's cut that wood. You have to have a lot of patience and make sure you measure everything before you... Wow, that was hard work. Okay, now we have to put the pieces together with nails. What tool should we use for that? Your boy Brandon Ahab surfing the waves. I guess you could use that, but there's a better tool. Look, I'm doing my best to have patience with you. What can we use to put the pieces together? That's right! We'll use the nail gun to attach the pieces! This project is taking a long time, and we have to do everything very carefully. What does it help to have?
Patience!
Come on, you've got this! That's right, patience!
That's what I just said.
Now it's time for some color. Let's paint the birdhouse. I love blue. Okay, now what tool should we use to paint the birdhouse? I think that would get pretty messy. Okay, I get it. The theme is patience.
It doesn't mean you have to keep testing mine!
What tool should we use to paint the birdhouse?
hell? How long have you been cataloging these?
Since I caught a sigil on the swing set in the background of the Let's Play Pirates episode. If I'd have blinked, I'd have missed it. But here's the thing, there wasn't a single reference until the acquisition. This is the complete log of all the references I can make out, and most of them are subtle, but they're there, and lots of them.
And usually paired with a message encouraging kids to ignore their parents or do something harmful. Again, it's subtle. It's not something that's overtly dangerous, not in the context, and it's always under the guise of a new adventure.
And you know this kid was also watching the show at the time of his disappearance. Mm,
totally engrossed, his parents said, and then just gone.
No police evidence? Not even footprints, trail and all?
No, nothing. Like, he just vanished. That was over 8 months ago.
And now this other kid, Lauren, same story.
So what's next?
That's what we need to figure out. I mean, obviously we can't say anything. It's a kid's show, for Christ's sake. We'd sound insane.
But it's not. These are not good lessons. Every episode has some very harmful instructions, and there's a thread of content that runs across all of it. References to Belial, to Mara, to Iblis. Every world religion has a figure that tempts and manipulates and deceives. According to Kate's log, in the last 20 weeks of this kid show, there have been over 40 mentions of these entities. It's alarming. I want to bring Peter into this, if you two are comfortable. This is really his area of expertise. Okay, let's get him to review the episodes that you've already recorded. I will cut the meeting recording.
How old is she here?
About five. I can't even imagine.
They provided two original tapes of the show, and they say there are more. Over the next few nights, I'm going to start combing those for more coded language. The puzzles, the anagrams, they seem to connect it to the cult. And based on what we have, I'm convinced that this is the latest iteration of the one Caroline's family's been tracking for generations.
The information we already have about the group ties it back to a religion that hasn't been practiced publicly in damn near.
So we're saying that this production company has been around since the Middle Ages? Is that what we're saying?
Either that, or there are.
So why her specifically, and why here?
I wish we could get our hands on that contract. I think it would be.
We don't even have any conclusive evidence that would suggest that she's still alive.
But she's in there, Peter. I know she is.
Whatever information Kate is getting is fragmented at best. And that's if it is actually Rebecca.
It has to be.
No, Caroline. We don't know. We have to hit the pause button on this. We can't do anything that would give away what we're doing.
Excuse me. I'm sorry. Are you in charge here? So what's the plan then, Peter? We just keep meeting and talking? What's our goal exactly?
Look, I want to try too, Caroline, but we have to proceed with caution.
We don't even know what state she's in, or if we could even get to her. It's been almost 15 years. She might not even want out at this point.
You don't know that.
You don't either.
Bottom line is, it's not safe. I mean, are we going to talk about David, or are we just going to pretend
he's not waiting around? If they're coming for me, they're coming for me. She's made contact with Kate.
But we don't even know that it's her.
It is, but she's too volatile. That's the tricky part. We don't know where she's coming from.
Kate, we've been working on this for 14 years. Please.
This is a terrible idea. We should be lying low, not diving in. You know what? This meeting's over. We're gonna take a break, and we're all just gonna come back when we can.
And you look look straight into the camera here and smile.
If I do this, you'll let me see her?
We'll have to get clearance for that. But let's just say doing this will improve your chances.
You know you just can't keep me in here. I don't know what you're trying to achieve, but people are going to be looking.
Okay, I'm all set. We can go ahead with your statement now.
Rebecca, honey, I am so proud of you. And I know that our friends are taking care of you while I'm away. You can... I'm not gonna tell her she can trust you. You've got me locked up in here and you want me to act like everything is okay? This is kidnapping, it's coercion.
Just
it's,
say what's on the paper as well.
This is kidnapping, it's coercion.
If you wish, one of my associates will gladly provide you with a copy of your signed contract. You agreed to this.
I did not agree to lie to my daughter.
Operation South Corridor, go ahead.
This is gonna take some time. Mr. Colton isn't exactly cooperative today. But I got something. I'll bring over the tape for editing.
And you've recorded all proceedings?
Still running. Can you send someone down to the lockup protocol?
Copy that. What's your authorization number?
543. Alpha Tango Alpha 67.
Security escort will arrive in 90 seconds. You have clearance. Stop recording.
All right, Mr. Colton. This is how you're going to behave. We'll do what we can with what you gave us.
Alice sat with her eyes closed, imagining she was still in Wonderland. But she knew that if she opened her eyes, everything would go back to normal. The instrument she heard would become grass blowing in the wind. Rings of smoke from the caterpillar would become the ripples on the pond. The noise of teacups returning to the sound of bells on sheep, and the queen's loud voice would become a boy calling for the sheep. All the strange sounds she heard would just be animals in the meadow. Wow, what a fun story. Did you all like that story?
Let's thank Mr. Sam Colton for joining us this morning for a very special story time. Hey, you all may know a friend of Mr. Colton's. You can watch her on her very own hometown hit show on Kensdale's Public Access channel. Do you know what show that is? That's right, my friends. Now, parents, on your way out today, please consider donating to the library's renovation fund so we can have even more great programming like we did today. Right, a major goal of the renovation is to create a special place for your little ones to read and dream. In the very own Kids Corner, with a state-of-the-art activity center and expanded selection for early readers. Now, remember, we can't do it without your support.
That new Kids Corner will open up a whole new world where your kids will be able to feed their imagination and fuel their own adventures.
That's
I
right.
can't wait to see such a special place come to life.
Yeah. Thank you again, Mr. Colton. And I look forward to seeing every one of you back here Thursday for a special production of The Very Silly Groundhog by our friends at Blue Fairy Puppet Theater. Okay, bye.
Bye.
Hey, thanks for filming again for the archive.
Daddy, did he turn off the camera?
No, I'm about to.
And I'll catch you later.
Make a film.
Didn't expect to see you at story time.
Okay.
Well, I'm a sucker for that Cheshire cat.
Perfect, yeah, give me what you got.
You know, I have to say, I just love seeing that connection you've made with the kids here.
I love it.
Something else.
You're my favorite jumper.
Do you have a minute?
Look at that.
Communication is stable, but her brain activity is severely out of balance.
Noticing more of that on the readings later. Keep a monitor on the nerve functions around the brain. Those always go up right before an incident. Excuse me, this corridor isn't scheduled. Hey, excuse me! Hey!
What's your favorite thing about where you live? Oh, that sounds nice.
My favorite thing is how safe and cozy my neighborhood feels.
Does it, Willie?
Yeah. I mean, most of the time.
Do you feel safe where you live? Yeah, me too. Even places that look safe sometimes aren't. In your neighborhood, there are lots of things that can hurt you. There are people who can hurt you, too.
Amanda, should we really be talking about this?
And that makes it hard to feel safe. And sometimes, when we don't feel safe, we can make big mistakes.
Amanda, can we please go home? Trust me, you'd rather be where it's warm and safe.
You know, you have to really think about who you can trust. Who is someone you trust? I trusted her, too. I wish I could still talk to her. There are lots of people I used to trust. But I don't know if I trust anyone anymore.
Amanda, you shouldn't go in there.
I thought you said this neighborhood is safe and cozy, Willie.
It's really scary back here, Amanda.
Sometimes it's good to go to places that scare us. You can learn a lot about yourself by facing something that scares you.
That's dangerous, Amanda. There are other ways to learn about yourself. Like by having adventures with your friends.
What's something that scares you? What if you saw that in this alley right now? Some people think strangers are really scary. But I don't feel that way.
Strangers? Amanda?
You know, you were a stranger when I met you.
To be safe, you should never talk to strangers.
And I trusted you. I think I still do.
Riley, I'm almost at the front door. I think that thing is following me.
Not him again! What are you even doing here?
Nobody wants you here.
I just got in. We need to get moving.
Can you even hear us? What is with this guy?
Why have you been letting this stranger mess with us this whole time? Can we please get rid of him?
What the hell happened in here? I'm gonna come check on you.
Come on.
why wouldn't you help us? I trusted you.
And what did I just say about strangers?
Let's get rid of this guy already.
Amanda, can we please go home?
Sure, Willie. I don't want to play anymore today anyway.
Did that thing do this? I'm really glad you're okay. Let's gather the tapes, quickly. I'll go grab what I can from the library, and then we've really got to get out of here.
I'm praying you hear this, so someone can get this to you. You can stay safe so I can protect you. Okay, please just don't watch the tapes. Destroy them. God, what did you think? How could I possibly involve you in this? I'm so sorry. I thought I couldn't. Everyone who's tried to figure it out, they're all dead. Please, I can't bear the thought of it. The letter I wrote, I was wrong. Riley, there is no higher calling. There is only suffering. If you never see me again, just please listen. It was so stupid and arrogant to think we could beat them. She wasn't ever ours to lose. She was already gone. I can't let you get lost too. Please.
Riley, I don't know what to... I am so sorry. Kate died because of me. My brother was one of the kids who disappeared. All I wanted was to find him. And someone came to me. They told me he was trapped and that the only way to free him was to smash the tapes. And I believed them. I brought you here to destroy these. I thought I was doing the right thing. The night she died, I went to your aunt's house. She'd been working so hard to find the truth, but all I wanted was to get Jordan back. I screamed at Kate to give me the tapes, and then... that creature. It was horrible. I pushed Kate out of there, begged her to run. I didn't want her to get hurt because of me, but then she... I think it was protecting the tapes. We didn't know. Kate didn't know. And now I've led those psychos right to her house. They're the ones who burned it down. It was to destroy those tapes. I know it. I saw the letter she wrote to you. I know she trusted you to pick up where she left off. And I took advantage of that trust to bring you here, to find the tapes. I don't know if you can ever forgive me. But I do know that Hamlin needs to be brought down. I won't be their pawn anymore. I will do whatever I can to... Riley, take these and get out of here. Go! I'll be right behind you. I promise.
Ha ha!